Hi all, welcome back. Today we are going to discuss about adverse drug reaction part 1. The topics included in the units are classifications of ARIA, excessive pharmacological effects, secondary pharmacological effects, idiosyncrasy, allergic drug reaction, genetically determined toxicity, then toxicity following sudden withdrawal of drugs, also drug interaction, beneficial interactions, adverse interactions, and pharmacokinetic drug interactions, and also methods for detecting drug interactions, spontaneous case reports and record linkage studies, and also adverse drug reaction reporting and management. In this section, we are discussing about the classification of ARIA. Let's come into the topic adverse drug reaction. So I have written here ADR and AD. What is ADR? Adverse drug reaction, and ADE means adverse drug event. Is that word similar, or what is the difference between these words? So this word adverse drug reaction and adverse drug event is always confusing. So it's better to know what is adverse drug reaction and adverse drug event before we are moving to further about adverse drug reaction. So you know that an adverse drug reaction means a noxious or undesired effect that are occurring when you are on a taking a drug, or when people are, or patient is taking a drug for his normal doses, for a therapy, prophylaxis, or to modify any physiological function. But adverse drug event is not like that. Adverse drug event can occur when the patient is under treatment, but we can't say it is necessarily or it is particularly due to that treatment. So that is the difference. So adverse drug reaction can be directly related to or is directly related to the treatment or the drug, whereas adverse drug event not exactly related to the treatment. So we can say as an ADR or adverse drug reaction is a type of adverse drug event whose cause can be directly attributed to a drug and its physiological properties. That is, adverse drug reaction is occurring despite appropriate prescribing and dosing, whereas adverse drug events also associated with inappropriate use of the drug or other confounders that occur during the therapy but are not necessarily caused by the pharmacology of drug itself. These adverse drug events can also happen due to medication errors also. Let's get into the details. The World Health Organization defines an adverse drug event as any untoward medical occurrence that may present during treatment with a pharmaceutical product but which does not necessarily have a causal relationship with this treatment. So this adverse drug event is also occurring while the patient is on treatment, but we can't necessarily say it is due to that particular treatment. And the World Health Organization defines an ADR as a response to a drug which is noxious and unintended and which occurs at doses normally used in man for prophylaxis, diagnosis or therapy of disease or for the modification of physiological function. So adverse drug reaction occurs when a patient is taking a drug or having drug that has been administered for prophylaxis or diagnosis or treatment of disease or the modification of physiological function. At that dose, the patient will be responding adversely. That is called as adverse drug reaction. And ADR is a type of adverse drug events whose cause can be directly attributed to a drug and its physiological properties. So, confirm the difference between adverse drug reaction and adverse events. Always the adverse drug reaction is related to the drug, whereas adverse drug events cannot be necessarily related to the drug. As I mentioned before, adverse drug events can also be caused due to medication errors. So, under that concept, National Coordinating Council for Medication Error Reporting and Prevention, that is NCCMERP, defines adverse drug events as any preventable event that may cause or lead to inappropriate medication use or patient harm while the medication is in the control of the healthcare professional, patient, or consumer. Similarly, as adverse drug events, adverse drug reaction, there is another word called adverse drug effect. So we can say adverse drug reaction and adverse drug effect is an interchangeable word. Like, an adverse effect is seen from the point of view of the drug, whereas an adverse drug reaction is seen from the point of view of the patient. Let's move on to the classification of adverse drug reaction. Traditionally, adverse drug reaction have been classified into two types. This classification is also known as Rawlins-Thompson classification. So according to Rawlins-Thompson classification, adverse drug reaction can be classified as type A reactions and type B reactions. Now, at this point of time, adverse drug reaction has been classified as type A, type B, type C, type D, type E and type F classification presently. So that is called as ABCDEF classification of adverse drug reaction. So type A reaction, that can also be referred as augmented reactions, which are dose dependent and predictable on the basis of the pharmacology of the drug. And type B reactions, called as bizarre reactions, which are idiosyncratic and not predictable on the basis of pharmacology. So that's the main difference between type A and type B. Type A is predictable with the pharmacological effect of the drug, whereas type B cannot be predicted with the pharmacologic effect of the drug. Comparing type A and type B, type A is pharmacologically predictable. Type A is dose dependent, but we can't say type B clearly as a dose dependent effect or reaction. And normally, type A, that is pharmacologically associated adverse reaction, are most common. And type A can be detected in its clinical development. That means at the development of the drug itself, we can detect the type A adverse drug reaction, whereas type B will be determined or detected after licensing of the drug, or like it is a long-term effect that is unpredictable. And type A reaction or type A adverse drug reactions mortality rate is low compared to type B reactions. And type A adverse drug reaction can be managed by reducing the dose of the particular drug that caused this reaction, whereas type B adverse reaction can be managed by completely discontinuing the therapy. So that is the main difference. These are the main difference between type A and type B adverse drug reaction. So this table explains more about the type A and type B reactions, and this has been adopted from the etiology and pathogenesis of adverse drug reaction written by Hausmann, Oliver, Signer and Benham. So according to this table, we can say type A pharmacological or type A pharmacologically dependent adverse drug reactions are like due to pharmacological effect of drug, like side effect that can be drug interactions and all that. And whereas type B reaction is mostly like hypersensitivity reaction, that is either due to non-specific mechanism or like specific immune reactions like allergies. So the type B hypersensitivity reactions then can be due to non-specific as well as specific immune reaction. This non-specific mechanism is due to defective or absence of some enzymes, or like cytokine disbalance of inflammatory mediators, and non-specific mast cell degranulation. And these true allergies are either due to immunoglobulin E mediator, or due to immunoglobulin G mediated cytotoxicity, or due to immune complex deposition, or due to T cell mediated reactions. I'm not moving into detail about this reaction since we have to cover only this much portion. I will be attaching the literature with this, so you can go on and check in detail about all this type A and type B. That will be helpful for improving your knowledge. As I told in the first class, we are discussing based on the exam or examination aspect. So I'm not dragging the topic too much that you will be feeling that this is such a vast topic and you will be skipping the portion. So we are looking in the point of examination basis. As I told before, initially it was type A augmented reactions and type B bizarre reactions. Subsequently, two further types of reaction were added, reaction related to both dose and time and delayed reactions. So the last categories can be split into two, time related reactions and withdrawable effects. So by that, there comes type C, type D and type E adverse drug reaction. And recently, a sixth category has been proposed, that is unexpected failure of therapy, and that is type F adverse drug reaction. Let's discuss more about type A, B, C, D, E, and F categories of or classification of adverse drug reaction. And this table has been adopted from Adverse Drug Reaction Definition, Diagnosis, and Management, written by authors Edward Iyer, Aronson, J.K. So, according to this, type A, that is dose-related or augmented adverse drug reaction. So, it's like commonly occurring type of adverse drug reaction and will be related to the pharmacological action of the drug. We can predict the drug because at the time of clinical development itself, we are familiar with the adverse drug reaction that can be caused by this drug and has a low mortality rate. Examples like digoxin toxicity, serotonin syndrome with serotonin reuptake inhibitors, and also like side effects due to like anticholinergic effects of tricyclic antidepressants. These are all examples of a dose-related or augmented or type A adverse drug reaction. So as I told before, the management is like reducing the dose of that particular drug. So we are managing these type A reactions are by reduce dose or withhold or like consider effects of concomitant therapy. So now next one is non-dose related type B or bizarre reactions. So these are uncommon reactions and not related to pharmacological action of the drug. These are unpredictable. That means that are dictated only after licensing the drug and it has a high mortality compared to dose related or type A adverse drug reaction. The examples are like immunological reactions like penicillin hypersensitivity reactions, or like allergic reactions like acute porphyria, malignant hypothermia, or pseudo allergy due to, or like ampicillin rash. So the management is to withhold and avoid in future. This particular drug should be avoided or withhold. And next one is dose related and time related or type C adverse drug reaction, also called as chronic adverse drug reaction. So these are also uncommon adverse drug reactions and related to the cumulative dose, that means the total dose of the drug taken by the patient. So the examples of chronic adverse drug reactions include hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis suppression, that is induced by corticosteroids. So for managing the type C adverse drug reaction, we have to reduce the dose or withhold the medicine, or we have to sometimes this withdrawal have to be prolonged till the adverse drug reaction subsides or goes completely. Next one is a type D, that is also called as time related adverse drug reaction, that is mnemonically called as delayed adverse drug reaction. This is also uncommon and usually dose related and occurs or become apparent sometime after the use of the drug. This adverse drug reaction is not like detected or expressed so suddenly after the treatment. It is like after a particular period of time this adverse effect is coming into progression and we are noticing the adverse drug reaction later after the treatment only. So the examples are like teratogenesis, then carcinogenesis, tardive dyskinesia, etc. It is often intractable. Next one is type A adverse reaction or withdrawal adverse drug reaction, mnemonically called as endofuse drug reaction. These are also uncommon type of adverse drug reaction, occurs soon after the withdrawal of the drug. For example, opiate withdrawal symptoms, myocardial ischemia after the beta blocker withdrawal. So for managing this type A adverse drug reaction, either we have to reintroduce the drug or withdraw the drug slowly. And the last category, type F, this is also called as unexpected failure of therapy, also called as failure adverse drug reaction. This is common and it is also dose related and often caused by drug interactions as well. Examples like inadequate dosage of an oral contraceptive, particularly when used with specific enzyme inducers, will cause the complete failure of oral contraception. So the management is by increasing the dosage of the medication or consider effects of the concomitant therapy. Besides the Rowland-Thompson classification, ADR can also be classified as primary and secondary, where primary is related to the non-mechanism of the drug, whereas secondary is usually occurring in organ system but can be explained from clinical pharmacology. Among the classification, Rowland-Thompson classification is most important, and you have to focus on Rowland-Thompson classification. It is like a frequently asked question in the university exam. So focus on that, study well, stay safe, stay healthy, take care. See you in the next section.